And how are you? Today we have another tutorial. Now it isn't the average tutorials that I usually do. This will be on Illustrator, so it is a graphics designy tutorial. Now this will I'll be using my welcome bamboo tablet that I got for myself for New Year. It wasn't a gift that I got from my family, I just bought it for myself. And so I just wanna show you what the tutorial will be on. So it will be similar to this bird speed up that I did, and if you didn't see that, make sure you go check it out. There's some really cool music in the background, and I think that you guys will enjoy it. So basically, what I did was just did a basic speed art on how I learned tracing. So the art of tracing is really popular, and it's basically the main part about graphics designing. So what a graphics designer does is he gets a drawing, and then whatever his client wants, he will trace around that with the pen tool, obviously, and then he'll use the brush to make some highlights on it. And later on, I didn't do any highlighting on this. I just did some basic Illustrator stuff, which is about tracing. And later on, the final one isn't extremely good, so don't judge. This was my first time, and yeah, but that wasn't extremely good. It was actually pretty bad, and the eye didn't match, but I don't really care. Anyway, this is just the outro, and that's it. So that was a video, and I'll be just teaching you how to do that. Now, I won't be doing the same bird, I'll be doing a hedgehog, and this is gonna be for a client of mine, but I won't be getting a huge amount of money. I'll just be getting like $10, I think. It's not a person that I don't know, but it is a person in my family that I do know. It's a cousin, actually, of mine. Anyway, so he wants me to just trace over this one, and yeah, and maybe if I will be able to, I'll do some basic brush highlights on it, but you need to have a good eye for brush highlighting, so yeah, I'm not too sure how it's good. And it's fine to have a pixelated picture, because you'll be tracing over it and you'll be making it non-pixelated, as you'll be using a vector program. So basically, I'll just go and open up Illustrator. Now, you don't need any different Illustrator. You can use Illustrator CS3, CS4, CS5, CS6, and CC. Now, I couldn't get CC on my computer on this one, so I just got CS6. And yeah, I also got 40 seminar, so I will be doing tutorials on that soon. Anyway, while this is opening, I'm sorry guys that I couldn't upload any videos lately because of I have been really busy with the new year, so it's really hard for me to upload every single day. And yeah, it's just the video editing takes another like hour, and then the video takes like an hour, and yeah. So if your Illustrator opens up like this, where it's not, all the parts are not joined, it's really annoying, isn't it? So I'm going to go to window, and I think it's application frame, and that's just going to make a frame for the application, and then you can just drag in this. All right, sweet. All right, I'm just gonna go ahead and go to file, new. And I'm going to make a new one, but before I do that, actually, I'm going to make a window and appearance, window workspace, and then I'll go to painting, maybe. Yeah, that looks cool. All right, painting it is. You can go up here and you can change up through, like, whatever one's essentials. You can go to tracing actually is better. Yeah, tracing's better. All right, now I'm gonna go to file, new, or you can press command N or control N, and I'm gonna make the name of this document hedgehog. I think that's how you spell it. Trace. Right, and I'm going to make the size A4, and I don't really care about the sizes in Illustrator. Now, file open, and I'm just going to open up the document or the picture, which is on my desktop. And then, okay, that's it. And that's going to open up this. And then if I zoom out by pressing Command, what's that? It's like this line in the air, and you can just zoom out. It's the one next to the plus button. And if you just press that one, you can zoom out, zoom in. And I'm going to go ahead and actually, I'm going to go to File, New, and instead of, I'm going to make it Portrait, I'm going to make it Landscape. That just makes it easier. And then I'm going to get the hedgehog, drag it on there, and drag it there. Right, I'm going to hold Shift while I size it up, just to keep the picture in ratio while I size it up. Right, I'm going to move that in the middle, and I'm just going to press Enter to make that. Right, now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and close this document, this tab, and I'm going to go to my layers, and right now here in Illustrator it's a bit more it's actually quite different to Photoshop, and the reason for this is that they're for two different types. Illustrator is usually there for making logos, drawings, all that type of stuff, where Photoshop's there for image enhancements, paintings, and like some cool effects on pictures, where Illustrator's there for doing the foundations. And what we're gonna do here is down here in the layer, we're gonna click this little thing and it's gonna make this image, and we're gonna press this image and double click it and rename it as whatever you wanna rename it. I'm just gonna name it Hedge. I'm not gonna name it Hog because I know what it's gonna be. And then I'm going to go ahead and grab the pen tool. I'm going to then close this and rename this hedge again. And then I'm going to make a new layer. And I'm going to rename this. Let's say, because of when you see your picture, there's two different elements. So there's this one, which is the body. And then there's this one, which is the fur or whatever. So I'm going to name this body Trace. And then I'll grab my pen tool and just make sure that it's there. If not, just click and hold down and then click and release until you have it. Sorry, guys, I might be a bit slow because I am using my tablet, and I'm not used to it. And I'm not extremely good with Illustrator too, so that's why I want to learn a bit. And the only way to learn is to practice, I guess. Right. Right, so zoom in if you feel more comfortable with it. And the way that I'm going to start this is I'm going to do the nose separately. Now, make sure that when you click down here and make an anchor point, that the fill is on and you want no thing. And I'm just going to make this brown for now. You can go ahead and customize that later. And then you just, with the pen tool, you just click on one point and then click on another point and then drag until you match around your trace. And then you go ahead and do this. Now, it might be a bit hard when it's with the fill on, but I like to do it with the fill so I get a kind of a feel with it. And that's what most of the other graphics designers do. Now, see when I clicked there, you'll see this little thing there. Now, if you don't do that, you'll just click there and see you'll make the line more different. That's not what you want. So if you just click on the dot, that'll get rid of the line and you can continue drawing. And make sure that that's a habit, because if that's not a habit, it just gets like really frustrating sometimes, and yeah. See, I didn't do it then. and it gets really annoying. And you just continue tracing around the body, which isn't too hard. And then when you hit this ear, you just want to just trace around that. And if the trace you have has any lines on the inside or whatever, you can go over that later on, but you want to make the outline first. And that's the main part about it. And see, if the arc doesn't fit your shape perfectly, you just grab this direct selection tool and you can move the anchor points around and edit the way or the path, what you could call it. I'm just going to add another anchor point here, and when you add another anchor point, you can edit it more precise. I'll probably be zooming in for this when I'll be editing this, so just don't worry if you can't see, because it is kind of hard to see it when I'm zoomed out. Alright. Alright, and then you can customize it. And then you can just select that anchor point and then just continue going around. Now, there will be some music in the background, so. Please don't worry. Just I'll bore you to death. Now, the Terraria series on the channel will be being uploaded soon, so if you're looking forward to seeing more Let's Plays with it, or you're just following along if you just want to burn time, that will be coming on the channel. But I have found this new game, Dota 2, and it is amazing. Me and my friends, it's a way for us to communicate later on, because I know that he plays it, and I saw my cousins playing it here in Russia. And what I was thinking is, like, whoa, I heard my friend talking about this, so I'll give it a try. And I've tried it was for free to download, and I was like, sweet, because I don't buy games, I'm pretty cheap like that. And then it's just become amazing, so I might not be uploading any Terraria for a bit. Maybe I did record some episodes, I just still haven't uploaded them because I didn't record it when I was commentating. I'll be doing a voiceover, so it might not be like as good as a live Let's Play, but it will still be coming, like they will be being uploaded. But in the meantime, because I'm playing so much Dota, I might be able to be recording Dota gameplay, and I really hope that you guys enjoy that. So once you hit this edge, you just want to continue on the place that you have decided. So because I'm going around here, I want to kind of just wait. And if you can't see, you can always move it out the way. Kind of guess. Right, sweet. And there will be a speed art of this video, so please just check out that video of this. If you just want to see this, of me making this without any like comments or how to do it, then you can go ahead and check out the speed art. The speed art link of the URL will be in the description also. Just tracing around, there's nothing interesting. There will be music in the background of this, don't worry. The pen tool does taking a bit of use in just a bit of a feeling for what you're using it, so it does take a bit of a while to get used to it. So don't kind of stress out if it's not working for you, because there is heaps of tutorials out there on YouTube that I always see. It's probably the most common tool that I see tutorials for. Anyway, this is the outline. Now if I go ahead and take away, oh no, okay, all good. All good. Alright, I didn't select that hedge body trace when I was making the trace. So I just have to go here, trace. Alright, so if I go ahead and hide this, I can kind of see the body. Now that looks pretty good. So now what we're going to do is we have to kind of make the spikes. But before we do that, I want to get the nose done. Actually, you see how I have to kind of match the fur perfectly with how I did this one. So that's going to be pretty hard. So the way that I'm going to do this is I'm going to... Okay, so before you look at the drawing, you should see, so because I've done these lines, when I do it, it's going to be really hard to kind of match it with the spikes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this. So I'm going to just go ahead and edit the anchor points. So I'm going to go delete anchor points, and I'm going to go ahead and delete... Just delete these. Anchor points. And there might be background noise, so I'm sorry about that. And see how that just drops. So far down, I'll have to zoom in for this. Right, so that's the leg. And see how that's gone over. So now when we... So now when we go over with the things, it doesn't matter because of the fur will be over this and it will look like it's been overlaid. But this one, see how the fur doesn't work? So we just edit that anchor point by grabbing the direct selection one, and then we just drag it over, and we make sure that the fur is not there. And we have to make sure that the fur is dead on, because then it won't look accurate. So now it's fine. And if we go ahead and zoom out, now that doesn't look perfect because of the fur is, but it will look better later on. So the nose has to be done and everything out that. When I was tracing, I did realize there's something. So all different types of 3D drawings, they have this lines that kind of represents where the skin folds. And when you're doing the tracing, you want to kind of ignore that. So because of, it's just going to make it really harder. You complete those lines later when you're doing the drawing. But I'm just going to go ahead and start the fur now. Now, this will take quite a time, so I will speed this up, like when I finish talking maybe. And I talk a lot, if you guys watch my tutorials a lot. And it's probably like, oh my gosh, just shut up. And I'm like, yeah, nah. I'm gonna rename this fur. Alright. Now I'm gonna hide this now. And I don't need that. Alright. Let's start. So I will start to speed up this video right now, and I'll come back when I finish tracing it over so you guys can watch. And then I'll put the music full blast on. Hang on, before I do that, you want to just make sure that the color of this is something different. So I'm just going to make it yellow for now. We can edit the color if we want. Right.
That way, I could be the one to set you free. Do you think about me when the crowd is gone? It used to be so easy, you and me. I could be the one to make you feel that way. I could be the one to set you free.
I'm back, and here we are. So I have finished tracing it now. Obviously I didn't do it perfectly all around, or I didn't not so ever perfectly, but I mean, like, it doesn't look good in like some spots. For an example, here, look, the spike is bad there in other places. So I'm going to change the color. It's getting a bit hard to see with purple, and I want to change it to something really noticeable. So black. And here I can see all the imperfections that I did. So first of all, I want to just fix around that. So by I'm going to do this by just using the direct selection tool, and I'm just going to select anchor points and I can change them around. So I'll just zoom into a spot where I don't like, which is, I'll just find one. So I'll start somewhere and I'll just work around. So this one, first of all, that spike doesn't look good, so... Right, that anchor point needs to go. So I've kind of edited it. It's not perfect, and then again I'm saying it's just a tutorial and I'm showing you. Now this is for a client, so I will be making it pitch not perfect, but like I have to release a video out now, so I just better make something and show you. And because of my due date for this is to him is not for extremely long. It's a pretty long time that I have, so I don't have to rush or anything. I can continue it the next day. But for now, this will do for it. And I hope that you guys kind of get what I mean by just going around editing it. Now, to edit it, I'm just going to show you just with a quick three types of rules that I have. So, for an example, you see an anchor point, so I'll just pick one. So, this one down here doesn't look very right. So, I get my zoom tool, I go ahead, click and drag, and I can see that little dotted square, and I can zoom in there. Right, that doesn't look correct at all, doesn't it? So, first off, I get my direct selection tool. I make sure that I am on the path or the layer. Then I click and you'll be able to see if you hover over anchor point. And then I can click there, and then you don't want to click and move it because that'll move the whole trace. You just want to click and then these little handles will pop up for each individual anchor. If you move them around, that can change it. And then if you move the anchor when the handles are popped up, that can also change it. And if you just continue to move that around constantly and just editing it, you will come up with something that will look better. Right. Now if you want to delete an anchor, for an example, you just hold down on this and then hover over and then click that. And then click on the anchor and that will be gone. But I don't want to delete that. I want to keep that there. And that's what I was basically doing. So if you probably saw that in the speed up. But you want to kind of make it as fluid as possible. You don't want to make it like stopped everywhere and stuff. If you're good at painting, you might want to paint this, you know, with the brush tool, but I'm not an artist, I've got to admit. Alright, so I just edited that one. And you can obviously go everywhere. Like, this one doesn't look good, but I just have to leave it for there, guys, right now. And I'll later on go ahead and edit it. But for now, that will do for us. Now we have to kind of get the rest of the two elements, which is the nose and the tail. So the nose is easy to do, the tail takes a bit more thought process, so I'll just get the ellipse tool and I can go ahead and just make a random circle. I'll just go and make this a different color, make it red, and root off the red nose reindeer. Bit too late for that, just missed. Anyway, so if you go ahead and twist this around. Now, when you saw me tracing it, I changed the opacity here so I could see the outline of the original text, because when you go over it, the thing will cover over it and it won't work. So you need to change the opacity at some point, because then you won't be able to see when you're changing it. So make note of when I change that, because it's really important to do that so you can get the most accurate one. Right, sweet. Now if I go ahead and hide that. Right, sweet, that's our basic trace. So it was more a bit more advanced than the bird speed up, but I think they'll be good, and make sure to check out the speed up for this. So we're gonna continue making this. So now we're just gonna rename these paths. See if that's anything, so I can delete that. Now, I actually don't know how to merge layers. Oh, these are I don't know how to merge, I'm sorry. It's Control E in Photoshop, but okay, so I guess this whole one is a layer. Oh, these are sub-layers. Right, I get it. So if I don't know how to merge sublayers, actually. Wow, that's a noob. These guys probably know, and I don't. That's crazy. Anyway, this part doesn't look that fluid, but I guess we have to work with that. Now, that's the hedgehog. Now we want to kind of make the inside traces and the lines. So if you go ahead and if I show you this one. Now, for this, I want to change all the parts to whatever percentage it can be, 50, 30, I don't really care, but I'll just make it 20 for now. This one I can make it. Alright, I just want to see how this looks in full percent. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Alright, now we still have that tail actually, so. Well, I need to do that. Alright, but I'll just skip the tail for now. Alright, so we have to go over these lines, and that's a different one. So I'm just gonna go ahead and. I'm thinking if I should make a whole different thing. So what I'm trying to think of now is, see the lines inside the outline, you need to kind of make those now. But you can either make them in a new layer or you can make them as sublayers in a layer. So. Alright, so what I have thought that would be the most best way is to make it in a sublayer. So the way that I'm going to do this is I'm going to go and just make a... Right, so I'm just going to go ahead and make lines, I guess. Now to do this, I'm just going to grab the line segment tool. Alright, so you use a pen tool though, you make no fill and you make this one color. So I'm just going to pick black for now, obviously, and I'll make the stroke maybe 4. So now when I draw it, I can have them curved lines, but there's no fill. And then I'll just go over these, so I will come back when I have done all these. Alright, so I have done it now. Obviously, it doesn't look extremely good, so. Have to kind of edit these. So it's pretty hard to get it bang on at the first go, so I'm just gonna go ahead and fix up these. And I'll do this not pausing, zooming it in, so I'll just. So in a couple of spots, I just like kind of did 2 anchor points. So guys, remember that the final product of these ones won't look extremely good because I'm not doing anything else. I'm just tracing over it. That's exactly what I'm doing. And it's pretty simple if you just have a drawing or a logo that you want to do. This is what you want to do with it, but instead, I'm just doing it with animals, so logo will be much more simple. So if you just draw on the logo, I'm just clean up this one, which should be that. Okay, I'll just I'm just checking over these. I just like to check. Alright, sweet. Alright. So I've done those. So we basically done all the thing, all the elements which take the most time. So wait. Alright, so we need to do the eye and tail, and then we have to kind of do the legs, and then we have to do some types of highlights, not extremely much, but at least some, so we will make the product look at least half decent. Alright, so we do the eye by just making another lips. And just resize this. Down to scale. Oh, sweet, perfect fit. Right. Yeah. Right, so it's kind of getting together. Alright, so now we have the tail, so it's going to be quite easy. Right. Now, if we put the tail down behind that, that looks good. Just Alright, so that's the tail, and now I'm just gonna search up a picture of a hedgehog and see the colors of it. So, alright, I'll just go hedgehog. I did spell hedgehog correctly. That's so cute. That's cool. See, you can kind of do that with the brush. Alright, so it's brown and yellowish skin. Brown, so it's the other way around. Brownish. Well, yellowish. Alright. The nose can be grey. It's black. Black nose. Right. The eyes can be blue. The hoistic or tail can be, I want it to be green, but I know it's not. The same color as this skin. Alright, so that's the thing, and now I want to kind of make an outline on the fur, whatever. Dark grey, and I'll just change the point up like that, and that kind of gives it some cool depth. But I'm going to change here in the uniform. You probably saw me doing changing around with that, with the bird one. You can do that, but I'm not going to do that because I just want to keep it a straight one. But for this, however, I can change the uniform in something a random, but change it. Stroke. Oh, sorry, I was using my computer. I should have been using the tablet. It's less loud. Alright, I actually don't need to change the stroke. I just keep it same for all these. Change those to 2. Change that up and change that. If I move this a tiny bit to the side, wait, wrong one. I'll just use a. See, it looks kind of joined. Sweet, it's done, and this one can do that. So we're just messing with the aesthetics here. Now with this one, I do want to make an outline too, so, but I'll change it as a different color. So I'll make it maybe orange, and I'll make the stroke a couple, so it looks like that. And then it's starting to look pretty cool. However, can you see this one I did here? I didn't mean to do it, but it actually happened. So it kind of gives it its 3D-ness. So we are missing something though. I think it's like there. So I'm just going to go ahead and add that. I'm gonna make sure it has no fill. Right, sweet. And then if I can make another one. Alright, so that's just gonna give it its depth. Now, obviously, it didn't join correctly, so I'm going to make it join correctly. Right, sweet. And this one doesn't look right. Alright, so it's joined in that, and that makes the legs look a bit more 3D. So now, after you've got all those in lines and stuff, so you can see one side of the leg and the other side of the legs, we are going to put this in Photoshop and we might do some effects, I'm not too sure. But before we do that, I'm just going to quickly change this tail to the... Alright, sweet. So now we're going to put this in Photoshop. So I'm going to just go and save file, save as, and I'm just going to do desktop, and I'm going to make it Hedgehog. Now... Fortunately, all Adobe programs can be put into other Adobe programs. So if you're not sure what Adobe is, it's just the company that makes Photoshop, Illustrator, Premiere Pro, CS6, everything, like all the graphics designing stuff. And that's what it makes it, Adobe Bridge and all that stuff. So all that stuff can open up Adobe programs. Adobe files. So Photoshop CS6 can open up Illustrator files. Premiere Pro can open up Photoshop files. So yeah, so you don't need to worry about the project files. So you don't need to save them as JPEGs. You can open up them up as a project file. Makes it convenient. So on Photoshop, we meet again, Photoshop. I'm going to go to File Open or Control Command O. And I'm just going to open up Hedgehog AI. That's how I know it is, the file. So it isn't brilliant, the end result of the trace, but it does look a bit better than just the normal thing without. So as you can see, it has no background layer, which we want background, so it's just transparent. So we're going to grab the brush tool, I'm going to make a new layer, I'm going to change the size maybe, I'll just show you, give you an example, so 40 pixels, so remember it's pixels, so 40 is pretty small still, and then you just change the hardness. You want to make, well, and no, wait, change the opacity you want to around maybe 30, 20, and when you draw on it, it will give that shape effect, and then you can draw around however you like and stuff like that. I just had to do that, you know. Oh, see, so when you put it in Photoshop, it's pixel stuff, so it's not vector, but when you're in Illustrator, no matter how far you zoom in, it's always going to be one straight line, so... See, it's not pixel oriented Illustrator. That's why it's better to do all your logos in Illustrator, because it can be sized up how much it wants and you'll still see no pixels. So Illustrator is a bit more smarter than Photoshop. I'm sorry, Photoshop, but it kind of is. So, Alright, so I'm just going to teach you how you can do this. So you get your brush tool, you change it to around 40 pixels, and then you can just trace over it, going with one and then going with a second one, and then just tracing over it again. And then once you got the dark outline done, you can go ahead and make it a bigger size by making it around 100, and then you can make, but then you have to make sure that the opacity is much more lighter, so you go around 10, and then you just go around like that. See, it's going from dark to lighter. And I hope you guys get what I mean, but I'm not good at this stuff, so it's not going to be good how I do it. So that's why I'm not even going to try and attempt it, and I just keep it with the trace. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure to check out the speed up video, but it's probably too late now because you've already seen me how to do it. But the speed up video has cool music, and I have the same music in all my videos because copyright reasons in with YouTube, I don't want copyright strikes, and they're not good for your channel, so I'm just going to keep it safe. Anyway, remember to remember the principles of design, and see ya, I'm out. Happy New Year.